Welcome to the fourth session of the chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In this module, we will see about the secondary treatment of sewage. In the last module, we had studied about primary treatment or physical treatment, in which it involves two steps, filtration and sedimentation. Filtration means the floating debris is removed, and in sedimentation, the grit, which consists of soil and small pebbles, is removed. And the primary effluent which is formed, the primary effluent after the primary treatment, is passed on for secondary treatment. The secondary treatment is otherwise called as biological treatment. Next is the secondary treatment, or it is called as the biological treatment. Biological, here comes the role of microorganisms, okay. And the primary effluent after the primary treatment, it is sent to large aeration tank. Okay, once it has settled down, all the grit, that is a sludge which has settled down, and the supernatant from the primary treatment, it is taken for secondary treatment, and it flows into large aeration tank, and this allows vigorous growth of aerobic microbes into flocks. Okay, that means air is pumped at a very fast rate. When air is pumped in, we know there is a large amount of microbes which can be aerobic, and these aerobic microbes, they grow at a very vigorous rate and it form flocks. What are flocks? Flocks, it is nothing but masses of bacteria which is associated with fungal filaments, and it forms mesh like structure. That is, bacteria which is associated with fungal filaments, and it forms a mesh like structure. So inside the aeration tank, the aerobic microbes, they grow into flocks. While growing, these microbes, they consume the major part of organic matter in the effluent. I told you a large amount of organic matter is present in the sewage. So this organic matter is consumed. When they are growing at a very rapid rate, they have to feed on this organic matter. So they feed on this organic matter, and they reduce this organic matter present in the primary effluent. And once this is done, it reduces the BOD. BOD means biochemical oxygen demand. Biochemical oxygen demand means how much oxygen is required to degrade the organic matter which is present in 1 liter of water. That is, in order to degrade this organic matter, aerobic bacteria requires oxygen. So it gives us an indication of how much oxygen is needed to degrade the organic matter present in 1 liter of water. So greater BOD means it indicates that the water is highly polluted. Less BOD means the water is less polluted. Suppose you are discharging the sewage as such, what happens? The aerobic bacteria which is present in the water bodies, it will consume all, it will take up or it will drain off all the oxygen from the water, and only then it will digest the organic matter. As a result, what will happen? The oxygen in the water bodies will decrease, or it will deprivate at a very fast rate, and that is going to affect the life of aquatic organisms which is present in the water bodies. So initially, in the sewage treatment plant, they digest the organic matter and thus brings down the BOD, or biochemical oxygen demand. So once the BOD of the sewage water, it is reduced significantly, that is, the organic matter, it digests the organic matter is digested by the aerobic microbes, and thus the BOD comes down, and the effluent is then from the aeration tank, it is then passed to settling tank, where the bacterial flocks are allowed to sediment, and this is called as the activated sludge. So from here, from the aeration tank, they are allowed, the effluent is allowed to pass to the next settling tank, and there the bacterial flocks, they settle down, and the settled down bacterial flocks, they are called as activated sludge. And from this activated sludge, a small amount of the sludge is passed back into the aeration, very small amount is taken back and pumped into the aeration tank, it as an inoculant, as a startup, so that it can undergo multiplication when it is aerated. And the remaining part of the sludge, small amount is taken into the aeration tank, and the remaining part of this activated sludge, it is pumped into another large tank, and these large tanks are called as anaerobic sludge digesters. They are called as anaerobic sludge digester. And when this is digested, what is digested? Other kinds of bacteria which grow anaerobically, that is the anaerobic bacteria, they digest the bacteria and fungi in the sludge. They digest the other bacteria and fungi. Okay, the anaerobic, what do you mean anaerobic? They do not require oxygen. So these anaerobic bacteria, they digest the bacteria and fungi. And when this digestion is taking place, it produces a mixture of gases such as methane, hydrogen sulfide and carbon dioxide. And it gives a very foul smell. But apart from the foul smell, these gases form the biogas. We know biogas is an alternative source of energy and it is used for lighting or cooking. And after this, from the settling tank, we have spoken only about the activated sludge which has settled down, and some amount of is taken to the aeration tank, and some and the rest is taken to the anaerobic sludge digester where it gets digested. And the secondary effluent, now it is harmless, less harmful, and then it is discharged into the water bodies. This is a flow chart. This box represents a primary treatment and this box represents a secondary treatment. Primary treatment is a physical removal. See, the raw sewage, it undergoes physical removal of all the debris by two processes, filtration and sedimentation. And after that, it is taken into the primary settling tank. And inside the primary settling tank, it forms the sludge, that is a primary sludge plus grit, that is forming the formed of soil and small pebbles. And the effluent, that is the effluent means the primary effluent. And this primary sludge plus grit, it is taken for landfills. You know, landfill is a method of filling in and reclaiming an excavated pits. It is used to reclaim excavated pits, or it is used to increase the fertility of soils. Okay. And this effluent, the primary effluent, is taken into for secondary treatment or the biological treatment, where the role of microbes come in, and it is taken into aeration tank where air is pumped at a very fast rate and it results in the formation of flocks, and this digests all the organic matter and brings down the BOD. And after that, once the BOD is reduced, it is taken to secondary settling tank, and in the secondary settling tank, it forms the settle down, forms the activated sludge. Some amount of this activated sludge is taken back to the aeration tank, which acts as an inoculum for the formation of flocks. And the rest of the activated sludge is taken to anaerobic sludge digester, where the anaerobic bacteria brings about digestion of other bacteria and fungi and releases gases called as mainly hydrogen sulfide, methane and carbon dioxide. And this is used as biogas. It is also a source of manure. It is used for burning and landfillings. And the secondary effluent, that is the topmost supernatant, is removed or directly discharged into the river. Thus, it makes the river less polluted. So, it is playing this STPs through. In this STPs, the microbes, they play a very major role in treating millions of gallons of wastewater every day across the globe. And the Ministry of Environment and Forest, they have initiated Ganga Action Plant and Yamuna Action Plant to save these major rivers of country from pollution. So STP, in the with the help of STP, the sewage is made less harmful and discharged into the rivers, and this is done with the help of microbes.